was doing some work in the area, and I wanted to talk to you guys before I finished up for the night. I'm with the 2020 ASMR Census, and I'm talking to people about their experiences with ASMR. Yeah, so I'm actually doing a survey for your city for the 2020 Census, and if you have a moment of your time, I can ask you some questions about ASMR and add you as part of our demographic data. Okay. Great. Do you mind if I come on inside? Okay.
Alright, awesome.
Yeah.
Lovely home. Yeah, if you don't mind, I'm just gonna set my bag down. Been walking a lot today, so it's really nice to set it down every once in a while. All right, so yeah, let me talk to you a little bit about the survey that we're doing with the Tingle Alliance. So it's a very simple thing. It's only about 3 pages, but it should take about 20 minutes of your time. So if you're not doing anything for the next little while, then yeah, we'll just kick back and I'll ask you some questions. All right, so let me just show you a form so that you know you're familiar with the questions, and I don't have any surprises for you. But it's nothing personal to you. It's just basic stuff about, you know, name, address, and then, you know, questions about your experiences with ASMR. So if you're cool with that, yeah. So, like I said, 3 pages. First page, you know, just basic stuff, name, address, you know, questions about do you experience autonomous sensory response, etc. Second page is where we go into a little bit more detail. I'll ask you about what kind of triggers you've had in the past and when you first experienced ASMR. And also on the second page, I will have a section where I actually do live triggers for you. So in my bag, I actually have a bunch of standardized Tingle Alliance approved objects that we'll give you a range of different sounds for you to hopefully experience an ASMR tingle. So if you're okay with that, I'll also include that because we use it for research purposes. Yeah? Okay. And then the final page, what do you like to watch ASMR for, and some of your subscriber habits on YouTube. All right, cool. So, without further ado, I guess let's begin. So, okay. So, what is your full name? And is that with a G? Yeah, okay. Any suffixes like junior, senior? Okay, nothing. And what is your address at this house? 1103, is that west? Yeah, west. Roundabout Drive. And are we in here in Riverdale still? Okay. Yeah, you know, sometimes I'm walking over so many neighborhoods and driving back and forth, and sometimes I forget where the city boundaries are. Dale, all right. And what is your date of birth? Okay. And how many years have you been at this residence? Almost a decade here in the Valley. Very good. And how many live in this household? 3? Okay. Yeah, you and 2 roommates? Nice. You guys going to college, or a couple of them are? Yeah. Oh, that's a good major. The market's really booming for that, I hear. Okay, so that's some of just the preliminary demographic information out of the way. So now we're going to start talking about some questions specific to ASMR. So The first one is always a fun one. Do your friends know you listen to ASMR? No. Yeah, me neither. I've always found that it's a lot easier if people just discover it on their own, because I have a hunch, and I think this survey will help reveal that most people don't experience the ASMR tingle. I think proportionately, it's a very small amount of people that can actually experience it, at least to any reliable degree. So, just introducing people you know to ASMR, they may see it and just think, oh wow, it's a bunch of weird, strange, sleepy time people touching a camera, but they just don't understand. So I guess by talking about it, you've already answered the first question. Do you experience ASMR, also known as the autonomous sensory meridian response? Had a feeling you do. However, some people actually don't. Some people don't experience the ASMR response, but they still like to listen to ASMR videos simply because they find them very relaxing in other ways, which I can definitely understand. Okay, so since you do experience it, how long have you experienced ASMR? 0 to 1 years, 2 to 5, 6 to 1, or 12 plus years? Yeah, so that's 12 plus. I mean, it's based off since your first experience with ASMR. I mean, ASMR videos haven't been around for 12 years, but yeah, definitely. So piggybacking off that, at what age did you first experience ASMR? Between 0 and 5, 6 to 12, 13 to 17, 18 to 29, or 30 plus? Oh, yeah, 6 to 12. Yeah, I would say most people who do experience ASMR, their first memory is between that 6 to 12 age bracket. We don't know why, but one of the things that we're doing with the survey is to get information on why that is and compare it to psychological and biological data and see if we can find any parallels. So it's interesting that you said that because most people do. All right. What is the first trigger that you remember experiencing? Personal intimate attention, physical touch, near ear sound, specific sound, background noise, or other? Yeah, I would count it under personal or intimate attention. Yeah. That's common for most people. Myself, one of the first times I remember experiencing ASMR was, oddly enough, at a Thanksgiving dinner when I was a really young kid, and I remember, just after eating a big Thanksgiving meal and having a carb overload, I went and lay down on the couch and, just chill out, listen to the football game. And just the clinking of the dishes being done in the sink, for some reason that sound was so pleasant to me that I remember feeling a relaxing tingle in me. And at the time, I didn't know it was ASMR, but looking back, that was my first response to it. But yeah, I would count a haircut as personal or intimate attention. I mean, 'cause it is personal, and there's a level of intimacy related to the closeness you are with the person. I've always found that when they use the small buzzer on the back of the neck, yeah, that's Yeah, that's when I get tingle sometime too. All right, so to describe your first trigger in detail, that was a give as many details as you can though. So we have a haircut, of course. Haircut, you said you were 7 years old. Were you alone? With mom. You remember what kind of day it was? Sunday. directly after church. Okay. Haircut at 7 years old with mom on a Sunday directly after church. Yeah. It's very nice that we can get very specific instances like that. Okay, so next up is, do you watch YouTube videos that feature ASMR content specifically? Mm-hmm. Very good. All right, since you answered yes, which year did you first watch a video for the intended purpose of experiencing ASMR? A lot of people will say the first ASMR video they saw was something like Bob Ross or maybe even like a Mr. Rogers video, but we're looking for a video that specifically was made to induce tingles. Yeah, very good. Yeah, so you've been listening to them and watching them since a lot of the original creators. That's great. Yeah, honestly, you know, I think most of the original creators are a lot of the best because, you know, they a lot of them just did it because it was interesting and it was fun, and that was long before a lot of money got into it. And so there's a level of quality to a lot of them that developed over the years that I always really enjoy. All right. If you can recall, what was the first ASMR video you viewed on YouTube back in 2011? Mm-hmm. Yep. I remember watching that. Gentle Whisperings haircut roleplay. Yeah, I think that was probably at least in the first 10 videos that I ever watched in ASMR back then. It was a favorite of mine for a long time. Okay, so last question before we get to the actual live tingles. How often do you watch ASMR videos per week, would you say? 0 to 1, 2 to 5, 6 to 9, 10 to 13, or 14 and up, which would indicate at least 2 or twice a day. 6 to 9? Yeah, so that's about once a day. Mm-hmm. That's fairly typical for most people. Most people who do listen to ASMR tend to watch them on a daily basis. Okay, so this will be the fun part. So I have some objects to give you some triggers on. So I will have to get a little bit closer to you. So if that's okay, then yeah, I will do the triggers next to your ears and attempt to induce an ASMR tingle. So the first object is going to be this crystal glass. There's a lot of ridges that make nice glass sounds, so yeah, feel free to close your eyes and I'll start from your right to your left, okay? After this, just, you know, let me know if you enjoyed it or not. All right, and to your left ear. You like that one? I've always enjoyed that myself. So you enjoyed glass. All right, next up. We have a large size post-it note flip book. time I'll begin again from right to left. And right, feel free to close your eyes. Kind of iffy. Well, we'll call that as an enjoy. It's a binary response. So, flipbook, enjoy. All right. Next up, we have a bag of ground coffee. Yes, I do carry this around all day in my backpack. Alright. So, this is always my favorite just because there's so many different sounds, and I think you'll like this one as well. It does smell pretty nice, doesn't it? Yeah, it's Arabica coffee. I probably mispronounced that, but it's very nice. I mark that as a definite enjoy. Alright. I have just two more. Sorry, three more. Next up is a standard kitchen twine potholder. Definitely enjoying that one too. Good. All right, next up, second to last, this is a beaver hair shaving foam brush. It's very soft, and I will actually be, if you're okay with it, gently brushing your ears for added effect. Is that okay? Alright. Let's start with your left ear on this one, actually. Good. favorite of a lot of people. Alright, now don't go to sleep yet, but I have one more. So the last one is a small travel size bottle of mouthwash. This is for the wet category of sounds because mouth sounds aren't allowed to be demonstrated on census takers by the Tingle Alliance, understandably so. So, last one. Ixnay on the Althwash May. Alright, so that does it for the live tickles. So, the survey is almost over at this point. Just have a couple more questions. Alright, so, which reasons do you enjoy watching ASMR videos? For the tingles, general relaxation or de-stressing, anxiety relief, sleep aid, or other? Okay, definitely for tingles. Anxiety relief. That's good. I'm glad a lot of the content creators can help you manage that. Sleep aid. Very good. When you use it for sleep aid, is that usually when you view them once per night?
Yeah.
Use it for general relaxation? Yeah, mostly just sleep. Okay. That's fairly common. Alright, and this is the last question. Are you subscribed to any ASMR channels on YouTube? Yep. Alright, and since you answered yes, how many? 0 to 2, 3 to 5, 6 to 8, or 9 and up? 9 and up. Wow, very good. You are quite the aficionado of ASMR. Who's, this is off the record, but who are some of your favorites? Yeah, she's really good. I really like all the special effects that she uses in her role plays. It makes the whole thing seem kind of like a short film. Yeah, he's good too. Yeah, his role plays are very in-depth. It really draws you into the character. It makes the whole tingle scene like more realistic in a way, yeah. Well, we're at the end of the survey here, so thanks again for taking the time out to, you know, sit down and do this for me. This really helps not only the ASMR community get a general a demographic of its users, but also it really helps ASMR creators know why people are watching their videos and how they can help tailor their content to that. So information here will be put to good use. Alright, well, unless you have any more questions for me, I can, you know, just see myself out and go bother your neighbors. No? Well, it's been a pleasure sitting down with you in your lovely home and having a talk, and like I said, this information will be put to good use in the ASMR community. Alright. Well, thanks again. I'll see myself out.